Well, neighbors say that it is very scary. They say that they did see the police, but they didn't initially realize how serious of a situation this was. Now, the police are calling these chemical bombs, and they say that if someone was within 10 feet of them and they exploded, they could definitely cause serious injuries.
It was a noise that startled the neighbors.
Something that sounded like a gunshot, and about a couple minutes later, I heard the same thing again.
Martha Swain says soon after, police and fire officials pulled into her neighbor's driveway.
Right. There were two explosive devices that were placed. One was in the driveway and one was on the porch of the residence.
Police say one went off as the residents came outside to investigate but weren't close enough to get hurt. Detective Sergeant Hunt says while the town has dealt with small bombs in the past, these stood out from the rest.
It was a chemical type explosion, bottle explosion, but there was an ingredient that was added to the chemical explosion that would make it more serious and more dangerous for anybody that was around it at the time.
Police won't say what the mystery ingredient was, but they say one of the bombs was placed within inches of a propane grill on the porch.
If the cylinder had gone off, if the explosive device had punctured the cylinder and that had exploded, it would have been very significant damage and fire, and it could have caused some significant injuries as well.
Police do not believe this was random. Sergeant Hunt says these people were targeted, and whoever did this knew the people inside, something that this neighbor found very disturbing.
But I assumed that maybe it was a fire of some sort, chimney fire or whatever. So I had not a clue that that's what it was.
Now, police say they are following several leads right now, and they do believe that juveniles may be responsible for this. They say in the state of New Hampshire, setting up a device like this is a felony-level offense, and it could mean significant prison time. Reporting live in Newport, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.